The choice is yours.
我拋過我先。 dawase obadie ye ma wone susha wudin ke sie ene wonyam o kreso pano ba ho ke sie a odi adum ba ene obede ebi ye yene na se ka wudin da wi wonyame wi wonyame ye ko tiwa ye bigera ene ye wo ya bra bom de bera da tinna ko beda am pa ebi da to ye mo ye tana betu ha ebi ha o tabi nyina o wedi ye pa o chos to se che ye ra o woni ko ne bi a che ye ra no e na ho me de am pa ebi ye di o so me tu me no so a sare ni nyina ra te ya ri che ya sa ma ye ayi ma sa mo a sa ya ma ye da a ho che mo a sa sa ye fi mo da ye ma so de ye fi mo da immigration is seven years from now. I can't create that. I think I'm going to be here. I'm going to phone any other day. Then so good Christo, you won't continue what you're doing. It was sick. Right here, Pat, I'm going to be here. It's so big, you're all back here. Pausa come. You may free up all. I could be in fear. Betting I said, and they are man. But on Saturday, they are doing your work. The better now say, it is over you when you bring so about the trees here, but it was a baby. Or yet a jar, the double pack used to be the meeting. Amen.
You will be seated. Even though Uncle Tim said that we are finishing. Remember that Jairus has been shared. You've not really
it's not even yet. Yaro, that's a good idea.
We come there, Jairus died, and lady
there.
So let us finish with this lady and go and find Jairus and bring him home and get him healed.
Mama, you trust go find him here, but he can find Yaro here in the camera.
Get him healed. Oh, verse 26. You are still in Mark
14:26.
And has suffered many things from many physicians. And spent all that he had. And was no better. But rather grew worse. You see, if you take the Jewish Talmud, there is a book called Jewish Talmud. It records how such a person should be healed.
And a church is in
So if you are suffering from this blood issue, you go to the physicians and the
priests.
And the physicians have done everything according to the law of the people.
No, can we be asking the man as it's here now?
And everything, the text says that it was rather growing worse.
Not as sacred.
You've done everything. You know, in Ghana, those of you from Ghana, I don't know that of other African countries. People sell medicine, and those medicines heals every kind of malady.
Medicine for cows will heal your waist pains.
You get into a bus, and these people will come and join you in the bus.
You being a public transport,
and they will sell everything. I remember I was in one of those buses.
And maybe now they will say a shame back.
And the guy was talking, just standing in front of me talking. And he said, I said, this thing can't heal my sickness. He said, who told you?
I said,
Then I told him I was having hair pain.
Okay, so it will
be hair pain. And because he just talked to me, he said, yeah, you can heal everything.
And now
so if my hair is paining me, medicine. So these doctors have done everything. Jump to verse 28. What should be your prayer as well?
In this essence, your Bible.
For she said, if only I may touch his clothes, I shall be made well. In fact, other, I think Matthew or one of the gospel writers says, if I may touch the hair of his garment, are you following me here? Just the head, just the end. You just have a little flavor of Jesus. All your burdens will be gone. Praise the Lord. The reason why your husband has been using you as a punching bag. The reason why your wife has been using his mouth to recreate you.
Maybe or you didn't know as a son or you yet.
Is that there is no Christ in that home?
If you know.
Hello?
Yes.
There's no Christ in that home. But if you touch just the hand,
so can attack me to my look at Krebia.
Immediately the fountain of her blood was dried up.
I say, Verse 30.
In Chimudu. And Jesus immediately, knowing in himself, power had gone out of him. Jesus knowing, when this woman touched the hair, Jesus felt that power had left him. Power, dynamite from Greek, power. Are you following me here? You know, those of you who know what was it, and Akotia, you said Akotia, where they mine.
Oh,
they
put
that one side of mine there and blast the land.
So, when
Jesus says, he's able to say that a power has left me.
Yes, you will say, what did you feel?
That's a lot.
I said, anointing.
You remember Jesus said, all power.
If you say, now, so to me, you know,
has been given
or their mommy
to me. Going therefore and make disciples. So that power, that dynamis, that authority,
it is up to me, dear.
Gives you peace. As soon as you touch the hem of the garment of Jesus Christ, and power will make Jesus Christ, and that will be for your salvation. Praise the Lord. Yeah. I can see that we are tired, so I'm going to say, man, break. Let us go and bring Jairus. Let's leave this woman. Let's go and bring Jairus. Anybody who has testimony, be ready.
What would that be?
Testimony time. Just be ready.
That's the day behind the crowd.
Let's leave this woman. A power has left Jesus.
Yes, I'm not here for you. I'm not
continuing with
that.
So jump to verse 32. And he looked around to see, yet before we go to Jairus.
He looked around to see
who had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what had happened to her, came and fell before him and told him the whole
truth.
You see, when Jesus does something for you, you can never hide it. You want to testify of the goodness of the Lord.
Oh,
you want to testify. You cannot even keep it to yourself. You're not a Christian.
And I'm a Christian.
This woman, when Jesus said, "Who touched me?"
Yes, said,
she was fearful. And she was struggling.
And hopeful.
To testify that the goodness of the Lord endures forever. What has the Lord done for you? What do you want to testify of the Lord today? Richard, play something for me. Let us just come and testify. If really the Lord can actually do something for you. today, yesterday, last week, last month, last year, what the Lord wants to speak to me. If you be a king, you have Does anyone have a testimony here, sister?
Well, that's still a people. I had a dream, and then one was telling me I've got a lump on my breast and it's cancerous. So I just wake up and then I realize, yeah, I can feel something in my breast. So immediately I kneel and I pray, say, God, I'm not going to see any physician. If it is your revelation, then heal me immediately. So you give God up to it. So the next morning, when I wake up early the next morning, I must make sure I have no more than laying in my breast. So I thank the Lord very much. Yes, up to now I'm not seeing any lump in my breast anymore. So thank the Lord for my sanctuary forever. About 6 months ago, I applied for a new job. So the nursing job back to a new world. Coming back from Philippines, I find it very difficult to work on the same world I was. So I decided to change from where I was working to a new world. So I got the job, but unfortunately it was in a part-time to a full-time job.
Before you tell me, we are full-time, so I have to part-time here just only 28 hours. Do you still want it?
So on the interview, on the panel asked me, from your record, you have been doing full-time your whole lifetime, but now working only part-time is 28 hours. Is it enough for you?
I'm so stressed. And then you go through the internet. You say yes.
She said, yes, I like that job. Though it wasn't enough, but due to how much of stress I was in, I said, yes, I will take it.
I'm saying, I'm going to hear about all the salary involved in the doctor's room. I'm going to
hear that. I didn't really think about it, about the impact financially and other stuff.
To be starting at the money, I'm going to be first feeling, to be honest, I was shocked.
So after I was giving my first pay, I realized, what is this? At least I have about 2/3 of my salary is gone. So I begin to realize myself, what have I done to myself? So I told to my husband, said, don't worry, God is in control. The one he said was, now you are free, there's no stress when you are working. No one is giving you more enough than going through this stressful events again. So I told them, if there's a chance for a full time, I'll reapply again.
Not to say,
so
So after 3 months, a new trust came to take over from the world I was, which is no more than St. Helier's trust.
It's a bit of my new office. I said, yeah, I'm going to be married full time because my apply for that job already. It's a future to deliver there on top of November.
So I confronted them, but they told me they can't offer me a full time now, but they gave me a chance. They will reconsider my application.
It's not a day. It's a day by four hours to reach.
So it was a bit difficult, but I was giving some overtime, one a day or two in the month.
You do some points, nothing
also overtime, but anything you need. And so they told me, no, we can't pay overtime anymore, so there was no overtime again.
No, no, it's so much for be effort. So I trust, no, I'm about to improve alone. I'm
on the back of the SR overtime. No, no, they have employed someone from their own trust to come and do the overtime, which was
in fact, I'm a real finance. Overtime, me and I'm here. After a month of
I was a bit sad because I was mourning a lot. Oh, why did they need somebody else to do the overtime? But I just wanted to pray or give to God.
And
we are not going to
say,
I'm
going to say,
my brethren, what I need to tell you is Paul always thinks of us. His thoughts are not our thoughts. Even before we need to murmur and then think of things, God has plans ahead of us.
It is how we can all work as a intimidation over time. The second, the following month, you are a manager, not a friend, according to the office.
So on the subsequent month, I was called by the manager to come to the office.
Now let
him know
something
here and
say, you say
they
are
more full time. And I went to an appointment which was looking
after a full time at that
work. So I thanked him and it was my thoughts and I was thinking, God, you are so good and you are so great. So I thank the Lord for going through all these 6 months of full time. Yes, today I've given a full time appointment at the world.
Yes, God is good. We're supposed to finish at 2 o'clock. It is 2 o'clock.
Let's take a phone. Do me a plan. Do me a
book. I'm just requesting only 5 minutes.
They stress the man in the
just 5 minutes.
It's my ending things.
For us to pray.
And I won't pay.
Now, back to Jairus.
Yes, I'm not hearing you.
He was ridiculed because the daughter was dead.
Now, what's so? Because the man knew.
Verse 36.
She will be the essential.
As soon as Jesus heard the word that was spoken, he said to the ruler of the synagogue, don't be afraid, only believe.
Now, yes, we need a similar occasion because he shall be the essential.
And he permitted no one to follow him.
Now, who will be our question? We did
the Peter, James, John,
James.
When people think that you are useless, don't be worried. Just trust in faithful Christians. And Jairus, your daughter will come back to
you.
Christ touched this girl.
Yes, you didn't say a car.
Because Jairus believed.
Because Jairus believed.
And the girl came back
to you. Now,
I'm giving you the assurance that Christ Jesus will heal you.
Say yes, your
all your troubles will be
healed.
Christ has sealed it.
Yes, you.
The Prince of Persia.
Or say she or something for no
whether for good or bad.
So bad or nobody knows. So she's kick on them.
Oh.
Or say Joshua.
In the faith.
Oh, did you know
in the Lord?
Oh, we are doing
trust in Jesus.
Or see, for which nation
is not be despair.
Or say, what happened?
You will never be tired.
And found the book will be out.
Jesus will take
care of you.
God bless you in the name of the Father.
In the
name of the Son.
And
in the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.